All right, we're back with the truck bed trailer project, and I had to ratchet strap the motor to the frame here because there's no more transmission back there. Nothing to hold it up from the back, apparently, so it just wanted to nosedive back as the body was coming up. There was 3 body bolts per side. And capture nut at the top, so all you need to do is get your impact and zip it right off. We've already got it somewhat up. Obviously, you're gonna have to disconnect if you're doing, you know, taking your cab off for some reason. We had to disconnect the brakes, the fuse box, the AC lines, the heater core lines. Some of this was already disassembled, and the rest were parts we sold or selling. So yeah, now we're gonna keep lifting the body off. So are you ready? Yeah. Wait. You said something in the back.
In the middle. You see it? On the cross
member? Oh. It's the shifter cable. I thought I fully disconnected it. Hang on. Alright, so unhooked the parking brake cable. It is now hanging right there. And right there. Now we just gotta get the motor out and see where the hell we're gonna cut the frame. Alright, we're back with the S10. So, I yanked the motor out of it late last night. And then we're left with this. We got power steering pump and the power steering. This has something to do with the exhaust. Not quite sure what it's called. We still have the center link and the tie rods. Gotta clean all that up. And then I'm going to come right here and cut on each side right there to get rid of all this. And then I'll make relief cuts back there to fold those pieces in and make the tongue of the trailer. I will have to figure out what I'm going to do with the gas line over there. Probably leave it as is and unbolt it from the frame and kind of, you know, zip tie it away, out of the way. And that's the plan. So, let's get to it. Okay, so as you can see up front, cleaned out everything in between the frame, took the jack stands from out from under it, moved it farther back right here by the cross member. That way, when I start cutting right here where that chalk line is, the front of the frame will just tilt forward. And then I can completely cut it off and work on making the tongue and get this out of the way. So I'm going to use the bandsaw and see how this goes. That's bending. This is where we're gonna notch the frame and pull it in towards the center. If I did my math right, this is 26 degrees to pull it in, to get it to the center there. So I'm gonna start by doing that much, and then we will see how close we are to being ready to go. I also have to measure from here to there. It's about like 22 inches and some change that I'll need. So I'll probably do more shaving off, because I think this is like 30 inches once I get it bent in a little bit to see how it's going to be. And yeah, so let's get to cutting. So, got it notched, as you can see over here. So now, I got the ratchet strap set up, if this tripod would work. And we're going to pull it together. Alright, so this is where I left off last night. Had a lot of fitting up, a lot of tacking to do. I forgot to pick the camera back up. But I've tacked the joint and welded the top on that side. And then here, I've tacked them in place. I had to extend it a little bit. The frame wasn't long enough. I had this 2x4 square tubing laying under the house where my scrap pile is. And went to Harbor Freight, got that hitch coupler. So that's ready to be welded out. And I'll be fighting with these to close the gaps on the top and bottom. And a little bit on the sides to fully weld that out. And then I'll fully weld this out. And that'll be enough to get this thing out of the garage.